Hello and welcome to UPSC Prep. If you want to prepare for UPSC when still in school, you are at right place because our channel helps school students to start prepare early and easily for UPSC. After clearing mains, the third stage of UPSC is interview for 275 marks. We also know it as personality test of the appearing candidates. We'll discuss more about it in upcoming videos. Friends, preparing from the early stage will never hurt you. In fact, it will help you succeed just like most toppers who were determined to serve the nation and started their preparation to crack exam at earliest. One of them is Vikram Grewal. He secured 51st rank in UPSC AIA 2018 in his very first attempt. Our channel provides information specifically for school students. Let's prepare early. Please like, share and subscribe for watching newly brewed content from UPSC Prep. So, no need to wait. Let's get started. Today, we will cover four topics of UPSC syllabus from today's news articles. Our first topic is Lal Bal Pal. Recently, to revive the independence era spirit of the Lal Bal Pal and to mark death centenary of Tilak, Pune-based non-governmental organization Sarhad is about to launch a series of literary and cultural programs to strengthen connections between Maharashtra and West Bengal. So let's see, what does Lal Bal Pal indicate? Well, Lal Bal Pal is used to refer the three national leaders of independence struggle. They were Lala Lajpat Rai, Bal Gangadhar Tilak and Bipin Chandra Pal. They led the extremist cause in Punjab, Bombay and Bengal respectively and took more aggressive stance against the British Empire in India as they did not believe in the soft and persuasive approach of moderates. You must have read about it in Chapter 11 of your Class 7th History textbooks. Now, let's solve related previous year prelims question from year 2018. He wrote biographies of Mazzini, Garibaldi, Shivaji and Shri Krishna, stayed in America for some time and was also elected to Central Assembly. He was A. Aurobindo Ghosh, B. Bipin Chandra Pal, C. Lala Lajpat Rai, D. Gangadhar Tilak. Correct answer is option C, Lala Lajpat Rai. Our next topic is ozone. According to a recent analysis by the Center for Science and Environment, while particulate matter and nitrous oxide levels fell during lockdown, ozone at ground level increased in several cities. Now, what do we mean by term ozone? Actually, ozone is a colorless and highly reactive oxygen gas that consists of three oxygen atoms and thus is also known as triatomic oxygen. It is formed by photochemical reactions between oxides of nitrogen and other volatile organic compounds in the air under the influence of sunlight and heat. Also, it is a harmful air pollutant at ground level and a major constituent of smog in atmosphere. You must have read about it in Chapter 6 of your Class 7 Science textbooks. Now, let's take up related previous year prelims question from year 2013. Photochemical smog is a resultant of the reaction among A. NO2, O3 and peroxyacetyl nitrate in the presence of sunlight, B. CO, O2 and peroxyacetyl nitrate in the presence of sunlight, C. CO, CO2 and NO2 at low temperature, D. High concentration of NO2, O3 and CO in the evening. The correct answer is option A, NO2, O3 and peroxyacetyl nitrate in the presence of sunlight. Moving on, our next topic is Scheduled Castes and Scheduled Tribes Prevention of Atrocities Act. Recently, a son and nephew of an MLA have been booked along with seven others for rioting and under provisions of the Scheduled Castes and Scheduled Tribes Prevention of Atrocities Act. You must be wondering, what is Scheduled Castes and Scheduled Tribes Prevention of Atrocities Act? See, as the name suggests, Scheduled Caste and Scheduled Tribes Prevention of Atrocities Act is an act to prevent atrocities against people belonging to Scheduled Castes and Scheduled Tribes. This act was framed in 1989 in response to demands made by Dalits and others that the government must take seriously the ill-treatment and humiliation Dalits and tribal groups face every day. You must have read about it in Chapter 8 of your Class 8 Political Science textbooks. Now, let's solve related prelims practice question. What are the other names given to Scheduled Caste and Scheduled Tribes Prevention of Atrocities Act? A. SCST Act. B. Prevention of Atrocities Act. C. Atrocities Act. D. All of the above. The correct answer is option D, all of the above. Our last topic for today is Panchayati Raj. Recently, the Panchayati Raj Ministry, in a meeting with 15th Finance Commission, has pitched for a 5-fold increase in funding for rural local government with allotment of rupees 10 lakh crores for 2020-21 to 2025-26. Now, we must understand what is Panchayati Raj. Actually, a three-tier structure of the Indian administration is called Panchayati Raj. Its aim is to develop local self-governments in districts, blocks, and villages. It plays a significant role in development of village, especially in areas of primary education, agricultural development, health, women and child development, and women participation in local government. Also, Balwant Rai Mehta is known as father of the Panchayati Raj. You must have read about it in Chapter 5 of your Class 6th Political Science textbook. Now, let's take a previous year prelims question from year 1996. What is the system of governance in Panchayati Raj setup? A. Single-tier structure of local self-government at the village level. B. Two-tier system of local self-government of village and block levels. C. Three-tier structure of local self-government at the village, block and district levels. D. Four-tier structure of local self-government at the village, block, district and in the state levels. The correct answer is option C. Three-tier structure of local self-government at the village, block and district levels. And with this today, we just scored total 8 marks in India's one of the most prestigious exam. That was all for today. Thank you for watching. Please like, share and subscribe for more freshly brewed content.